9, 1, 9, 2.
Unbelievable.
Here we go.
It's gonna
hang up.
This is so cool.
Hello, guys. We just landed in Bentonville Airport. It's in Arkansas. We're flying right now from California to Florida. I'm ferrying Sakata Trinidad for my customer, and I just recall, like, you know, sometimes flash happens in my memory, that on Oshkosh back in 2021 I saw a pretty nice aerobatic plane with funny name Gamebird, and I spoke to CEO of this company in Oshkosh, and he invited me to Arkansas on the home base of this airplane to visit them, and they will provide me some kind of demonstration and show me the factory and give me demo flight on this plane. It was back in August and July 2021. So, and when I flew from California, I just recalled this conversation, and I said, hey, how far is it from my way to Florida? And it just happens, it's almost on my way. A little bit up north, maybe 100, 150 miles, and I decided to do some a little bit fly around and stop here in Bentonville to speak with Philipp. He's a CEO and he's a chief constructor. He's an aerobatic pilot. He's an ex-champion of Germany. A few times in aerobatic competitions, he flew unlimited. So he's top of the top aerobatic pilots in the world, I believe. He used to work for Extra some days back in his history, and now he developing his own project, Gamebird 1. Let's talk to Philipp and let's see all together what they have here in Bentonville and his on the factory, and let's ask them to fly airplane. Let's go. Hey guys, I just arrived to Game Composite Company.
So this is the final assembly and maintenance area. This is the prototype that's 7 years old now, has about 1,200 hours on it.
It's the first one.
That's the first one, yeah. Uh-huh. This is number 46. This is number 28. That's the one you and I are going to fly in a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
And we're working on serial number 50, and serial number 52 is in the molds right now, which you will see. So then back there, we got our vinyl table. So that's where we cut vinyls for, you know, letters and paint schemes. So very few things are hand masked. Most of the stuff is, you know, cut by vinyl and then applied before the paint, so it's all symmetrical and the same.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, first thing we're gonna
so you produced 50 planes in 5 years?
Yes.
Wow.
This is inventory here, storage. So up there we got like 30 engines at the moment and 30 props.
Mm-hmm.
And then we almost always carry at least 1 year production worth of inventory, and you know, with COVID, this enabled us to never shut down.
Mm-hmm.
So right now there's a lot of money sitting in here. So
how many planes you can produce a year?
Like this year we're going to produce 22.
22.
And then next year probably 24, 25, not much more than that. But
and the whole production is here.
Everything, yeah. You'll see everything here. This is a rudder pedal, for example.
Mm-hmm.
So it's 12 laser cut pieces welded and powder coated. But you know, a rudder pedal on an aerobatic airplane is treated like gym equipment, not like airplane parts, so it needs to be a little stronger.
The whole plane is composite, right?
Yeah, everything, yeah. So that's
including
all
the wing spare, everything.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And yeah, then materials. I show you control surfaces over there. That's quite interesting. Then here, this is an elevator. I'll just hold this.
This is the elevator.
That includes 450 pounds of lead here to reduce the stick force per G.
Uh-huh.
And
so the weight is here already.
Yeah,
it's inside.
Exactly. Uh-huh. And that adds about 150 grams in paint are going to be added to this, but that's it then. So that's not much more than this.
Nice. Then, who was inventor of this aircraft?
I'm the main designer of it.
You?
Yeah.
Oh, so, cool.
Yeah. So this is composite production here, as you can tell, about 330 molds make one airplane. So you need a tool for everything, and that's all stuff. So the airplane design was roughly a year. The tooling design was about a year and a half, and then the production documentation was another year. So for every part, you know, for every single part, we have a work instruction where the workers need to sign what they did, and then for every single step. And then you have, at the end, you have an inspector signing off on each part. And then this is the, and then we have the travelers, the work orders, which contains the part number, serial number, and then the batch numbers here for everything. Mm-hmm. So that create, that makes these airplane parts, legal airplane parts. At the end, when the airplane is finished, we have around 1100 of those documents. And some of them, for a little rip, it's only one page. But then, you know, for the final assembly, the wiring loom, you have like a 30-page work instruction. And so it's quite a sizable stack of paper by the time you have one airplane.
So you have only FAA certification or EASA also?
Both.
Both of them,
yeah.
FAA and
yes.
EASA.
Yes.
Wow. And your customers mostly from the United States?
Mostly from the United States at the moment, yeah.
And you don't have any manufacturer in Europe right now?
No.
But you're not from the United States?
No, I'm from Germany originally.
This is why I'm here. Okay.
Yeah, no, but we just delivered one airplane to Poland to a friend of mine, Arthur Kielak.
Okay.
And then one is in France right now, and then there are six in Chile, three in Canada, and the rest is all here.
Awesome.
So yeah, that's the wing molds in here, then in here is the trim room where we do the dirty work. So, you know, these are all big extraction fans and filters, so the whole room gets evacuated.
Where is the glue?
No, that's all done out here.
That's
but
all
you
done
know,
out
if you
here?
Yeah, if you need to like trim something, you know, cut excess of. Yeah, that's all done in here. Cutting and sanding is done in here. So out there stays like halfway clean.
How many people works for you?
We are 72 right now.
72?
Yeah. Where the temperature comes in. Yeah. That's a bottom fuselage here. That's serial number 53 right there. And so the fuselage is top and bottom half, which enables us to put all the control system in before we close the fuselage, so they're really all the same.
So how long it took from start to complete the whole plane, the full production cycle?
About 42 days at the moment.
42 days.
Yeah. And about 15 days of this is composite, and then 8 days of the, no, 6 days is assembly, and the rest is paint. See, and in here you see how this all comes together. So this is basically how the fuselage comes out of the mold. And then the seats are bonded in, and the control system is installed. And only after all this, the installations are complete, then it goes over to paint. We work with PPG for the paint, so these guys are very nice to us. Basically, with these things, we can mix any color you can name. And yeah, the guys have all their fancy spray gears here. And it's quite helpful. So we can do, you know, here lots of different guns. That in itself has become a bit of a science.
Why you decided to name the plane a game?
Game? It's funny. Essentially, it's a toy. And it's a, at the moment, you know, everything, all the names, they seem to go back to simplification. Mm-hmm. And everybody who hears the name the first time said, that's a really weird name. I said, yeah, come up with a better one. And so far, nobody came up with a better one. Basically, this is all bodywork here. Yeah, and the machine shop, of course. And all this is going to change.
While we're here close to the wing, this is the main spar, right?
Yes. And it's a two-piece wing. So the you'll see next door, when you go next door, how they fit together. So this is a big hollow box, and this is a slightly smaller hollow box that goes into the other side, so there's no offset loads when you load it up. Mm-hmm. And
if I need to disassemble my plane, it's the same like an extra?
No, much easier. You pull each half off individually.
Really? So I need to put all the wing?
Okay. Yeah, and each half is 40 kilos. So you can put the plane apart and together with two people very easy.
How long it take?
2 hours.
2 hours.
From opening the box to fly.
Okay.
So I show you why. It's a, you know, I worked a lot on with extras and Sukhois and cups to put them together.
Wow.
And for a, you know, for a Sukhoi 26, you need 3 people and 2 days to take it out of the container,
yeah,
and make it fly. And it's that becomes very painful after a while.
Uh-huh.
See, that's a right-hand wing.
Uh-huh.
So if you want, this is, you know, not very heavy here. So this is the push-pull rod for the aileron,
yes,
that goes, there's only
all
one metal piece here. Then
okay,
we have 120 liters in each side.
Okay.
That's the smoke tank, that's 14 liters per side.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, then the tip lights at the end, of course. And yeah, this airplane is going to Florida to, I forgot, somewhere on the Keys. And some airport, the guy lives in an airport down there. And
mm-hmm,
that's gonna fly later this week.
This is impressive. How long it take to get certificate? I believe certification process is the most, like...
3 years, 4 months. 3 years and
4 months.
Okay. But we were the fastest in the history of EASA and FAA who did a certification like this.
Yeah, I can imagine.
And with 7 people at the max, so.
Wow.
But it also meant at that time, none of us had a real life, you know? So.
Yeah.
And
so you're completely involved in this business.
Oh yeah.
24/7.
Yeah, pretty much, yeah.
Uh-huh.
But if you're not, then you know it's not. It's probably not going to work, I guess.
I like this wood,
yeah,
handles.
See, this is another thing. A friend of mine in Germany, on the extra, you have a tube here with the
mm-hmm,
bicycle grip slid,
yes,
over, and he took off on a runway for an air show, rolled inverted, and then the slip, the grip,
really,
came off. Klaus Schroth, maybe you know the name,
mm-hmm,
and he just was lucky to put his left hand there and push. And so on this, you know, even if this like crumples, there's a steel plate in here and
mm-hmm,
a cross plate, so your hand
even
cannot slip off.
Even if something happens, it's still here. Okay.
Exactly.
I see. So on this canal, you have just some wires to...
Yeah, and so also, you know, if you, yeah, so also if you do an annual inspection, you know, these panels are in with 4 screws each.
Easier,
so,
right?
Yeah, so and then the battery, for example, is in here. So there's only one little fastener here that you need
mm-hmm,
to take off, and then you can get to the battery, and the battery is two little screws to get out,
mm-hmm,
plus the terminals, of course. But there's no, you know, there's no fairings to take off or anything like this. You don't have to disassemble a lot of parts.
Yeah, first time when I removed battery from my extra, it was pain in the ass.
Oh yes, yeah, tell me all about it.
You need to remove the front
seat
completely.
Exactly, yeah.
This took about a few hours,
yeah,
just
and
to get how what I need to do.
The tank is the same. The tank is a composite tank. You see it over there in the
mm-hmm,
shelf. And it's just held in by 2 carbon fiber straps.
This is acro tank, right?
Yeah, and that's 105 liters. So 25 gallons.
25 gallons,
mm,
okay.
So you can fly more than an hour just on the acro tank without ever switching tanks. So if you do instruction or upset recovery and you have a guy in the back that
mm-hmm,
you... If, as long as you keep it to 1 hour, the guy never has to touch the fuel selector.
Mm-hmm.
And so the other thing is this, the fuel pump sits right down here. So if you need to get to the fuel pump or to anything, there's just a little panel here that
uh-huh,
you can take off with 8 screws, and you get to the bottom of the tank, the fuel selector valve and the fuel pump.
Awesome.
So
easy to replace.
Yes.
Something happens, right?
Oh, yes.
And what is the endurance time with full tanks if I would like to fly it some
so you have
cross country?
330 liters in the plane.
330, okay.
And you cruise with like always over 200 knots if you want to. And so
200 knots?
Yeah.
This is my cruising speed?
Yeah. And then you can, so I've gone back from Idaho. You know where Idaho,
yeah,
Falls is?
Mm-hmm.
North of Idaho Falls. So one of our customers has a big ranch there, and I flew back nonstop to here, which was 1150 miles, and I still had 50 minutes endurance when I landed here.
1100 miles?
Yeah.
And how long it took?
Five hours. 5 hours, 7 minutes, yeah.
My God.
That was good.
Do you have autopilot?
Now we're working on it, yeah. We're working on the certification.
That's for the cross country, you need to offer,
yeah, yeah,
some...
Well, I still like to fly.
Yeah, I know, but 5 hours.
Yeah. Well, it's okay. Just fly low and it's more fun.
Man, it's so cool. It's 580, right?
Yes. Yeah, the only thing
horsepower,
we...
Horsepower 315?
Yeah, and the only thing we do, you know, we developed our own intake pipes and own exhaust system, so mm-hmm. we have a nicer looking cowling. Mm-hmm. And also you can take each tube off individually without removing any other
everything.
Tubes.
Okay.
So if you blow a gasket down here, you know, one of those intake seals, mm-hmm. you can take the tube off very quickly, change the thing without taking the exhaust off. And then we use the starter, this thing here, the vibrator, like you have in a Sukhoi, for example. You know, so you don't have a retard mag, you just have this shower of sparks, mm-hmm. and it starts very, very easy. And this has already been warm, and you very rarely need to crank more than 2 or 3 seconds.
Okay, so it's a hot start,
not a problem anymore. Not at all, no. And the other trick of this is that let me show you on the other side, the gas collator here. See the gas collator is on the cold side of the firewall?
Yeah.
So on most other aerobatic airplanes, the gas collator is here hanging over the exhaust. And so when you shut off and it's warm, it heat soaks. And on this one, there's only a very short fuel line from here. This one, you know, going from the mechanical pump to the firewall. So there's very little that actually warms up. So by mm-hmm. the time you do the proper heat start technique, it works all the time.
Okay. And always needed to assemble, it's just one wing from one side, the other wing from the other side, and screw them
exactly.
somewhere right here, right?
This one. No, you just have two big pins. See, these are the main pins. You just lift them up.
Mm-hmm.
It's titanium.
Awesome.
Yeah, and they are, as you can tell, they're not going to break.
So you just put this
Put them in from the front, and that's it. Yeah, so you put both wings in, mm-hmm. and then stick those pins in. And these are the drag anti-drag pins for the back.
And you just lock them, right?
Yeah,
this
exactly.
is the lockers.
These are blocked by an Adel clamp, and these are blocked by a little access panel. Mm-hmm. So you can see this when even in the back seat, you can see over the instrument panel and see if they're in the right place. And then another thing, you know, if you need spare parts like hoses or something, the maintenance manual doesn't read them as game composite hoses. They are Parker specifications, so you can buy a hose wherever you want.
Okay.
Also brakes and wheels, they're specified with the original manufacturer's name, and you can buy them at Aircraft Spruce, whatever. You know, I'm not trying to get rich on gaskets or stuff
mm-hmm,
like that.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So it's just common.
Exactly. Everything that you can buy common is listed with the normal part number.
Mm-hmm.
So you can buy it anywhere, and you don't need to rely on us all the time. So that's the...
Wow.
Here we go. And this is serial number 49. The blue and white wing you've seen over there is serial number 50.
50.
That's due in 2 weeks' time. And yeah, this year we started producing 2 airplanes every month.
Awesome.
Right on. Yeah, and then this is serial number 28. That's Stuart's personal airplane, my business partner and friend. And he lets us use this as a demo.
As a demo.
Then if you fly with smoke, the smoke refill port is here. So you just plug a hose in and then reverse the polarity of the pump and suck the smoke into the tank, and there's a pressure switch that switches it off automatically.
Awesome.
So yeah, wing tanks are empty on this one now. One thing to check for, you know, the hinges are out here. So
yeah.
You have an Allen key to take the whole thing out
uh-huh.
and just make sure there is a torque seal on here, and that's it. Then we have an aileron trim. So, you know, even if you fly the wing tanks empty non-symmetrically, you can always trim the airplane hands off,
mm-hmm.
which is pretty nice if you go like distances.
Eating up something?
Yeah, this has been, we've been on a couple of pretty rough runways lately with this, so.
So it's just like amortization?
Yeah, exactly. It doesn't do anything structural. It just doesn't look very nice. This is a bit like the Sukhoi, you know, you take
mm-hmm.
these screws out and pull the pin out and you can take the take the elevator off. Yes. Then elevator trim tab right here. The actuator is here. You can see the servo from the outside here. And as long as the connection is there, it should be all good to go. Yeah, that's it. Already checked the baggage bay. You have static ports on the side.
Yeah,
they shouldn't be dirty, of course. And
whenever you're ready.
Yeah, I am born ready.
Okay, you're ready.
Proper mixture forward.
Okay, battery master on.
Yep. Proper mixture forward.
Proper mixture full.
See.
Boost pump.
Yep, 2 seconds.
1, 2.
Yep, mixture back.
Mixture back.
And in the brakes.
Okay, I'm on the brakes right now.
Very good. And then crank with the hand on the mixture. And when it fires,
straight to the east of the lake, and then we come out from underneath the Charlie Bay and then fly into some aerobatic if you want.
Sure.
Right on.
Aerobatic, is this what I'm trying to do?
I guess so, yes.
This is why I'm here.
Yep, exactly. That's a friend of mine who has a husky there that lives green hanging.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. It's a little short for this, you know, it's very rough, but with the Piper Cup or with the Husky, it's really nice.
Everyone, for the big wheels.
Yeah, exactly. And good suspension.
So, we can climb already on us?
Yep, all good here.
Okay. I don't remember this airspace structure around.
Yep.
So, what is minimum speed you use for vertical maneuvers, like loop?
Oh, you can fly a loop from 100 knots if you want. It's not very round, but you can fly the airplane around. You can start from here, no problem, if you want to.
Okay. Yeah, let's start from a loop.
Yeah, yeah.
I'll do just basic maneuvers because I didn't fly everybody for a long time.
Okay, whatever you want to do.
So I'm 60. Let's go.
Let's go. Nice.
Okay. Let's try vertical.
Okay.
Yeah, here. Ready?
All ready? Yes, very good. Good time. Nice.
really short week.
Yeah.
After extra.
Yeah, it's in fact only this much shorter. It's 12 centimeters shorter than extra inside.
Okay, can I try roll?
Of course. That's what we're here for.
Okay.
Nice. Good job. Try another one. You know, don't anticipate the stop, just at the end, just put the stick in the middle, it should be fine.
One more time?
Yep.
Okay, cool.
So, can I show you a slow speed real quick?
Please, show me whatever you want.
Okay.
I'm faster right now.
Alright, I got the update. But first, we just do regular slow speed stuff. So, just all the things in the middle. Close up, here you go. And just fly around like that.
Nice.
And then
62 knots, but it's still flying, right?
Yeah.
It's unbelievable.
There, then you recover, and immediately you build speed, and you can bring the nose up inside. So, the next thing is to show you is a flat fin recovery. Very easy, so we're going to pull up from 100 to 110 knots, go to vertical, come off and do a flat spin.
Yeah, there let's go. Let's do it.
So, vertical, and then push, and then up here, keep the nose up, lift, push, aileron to the lift, so one turn.
And then flat spin.
That's flat spin, two turns, and I'm going to stop it on three turns. Three turns. That's it. Okay, now from 100 knots, we're going to do a loop.
Unbelievable.
And then like from 125 knots, we're going to do a vertical line with one on water, one, and two, and stall turn. I'll go back into the salt and a little bit.
Yeah, that's good.
So we're going to do a little bit low, right foot, here we go, upper, and stop, then we're back in this place. No drama.
Nice. What was that?
An outside tumble.
Yeah.
And I can show you an inside tumble real quick.
Yeah, for sure.
So
give me my third class.
Right on, so here we go, right hook, stick left, here we go, and it's gonna hang off, and we stop inverted and fly away from it.
This is so cool.
Here we go, and it's gonna hang off, and we stop. And then the last thing I'm going to show you is we're going to, on the 45 upline, 1.5 positive flicks and stop inverted.
Okay.
So we're going to pull up to the vertical and at 140 knots, I'm going to do the flick and we stop inverted.
Okay.
All right, here we go. 45. 3, 2, 1, go. And that's it. Very easy.
My god, it's awesome.
Yeah, they're pretty good fun, those things. And what else? I showed you. Yeah, vertical rollers, quite good fun.
Yeah, let's go.
Yeah, we're gonna dive. And I'm gonna do a quarter roller first, two or four, and 1.5.
Okay.
There we go. Pull up to him. And come out of it. Very nice. Very nice so far. Yeah, don't do anything. Good. Keep it there. Yeah, nice one. Good job.
to you.
Yeah, for the first time, without me telling you anything, this was really, really good.
It's so much appreciated. It's not fair, I still have extra.
No.
Or some kind of experience with tailwheel.
Yeah, it definitely helps, exactly.
And it's so awesome, thank you so much.
Oh, thanks for coming.
I appreciate cool. your time today.
Very welcome.
That's good enough.
Tiny bit more. Yeah, perfect. Now both ways are in. All right.
Oh my god.
Right on. Good job.
Philipp, thank you so much.
No, you're very welcome.
I appreciate it. It's awesome.
Well done.
Awesome.
It was really cool.
Yeah.
You did really well, huh?
I appreciate it. Thank you so much. I just got the good words from 4 times German champion. One more time.
Yeah.
How much is the bird?
5:15.
5:15 is the delivery time?
Is early March 2023.
Oh, 2023.
Yes.
So if I put deposit today, I can get my plane
late
next
March.
Year, like March 2023.
Yes, yeah.
Okay, guys, you see, this is what you need to know about game bird. If you would like to have this bird next year, 5:15, and what is the deposit?
10%.
10% deposit. And this bird can be yours.
Perfect.
And this is the perfect plane, I can tell you. As an owner of Extra, I can tell you it's an absolutely real competitor and it's a really cool plane. Enjoy the flight.
Thank you very
just
much.
Had a lot of fun.
Thank you very much. Appreciate the nice words.
Thank you so much.